In our previous tutorial, we looked at setting up of templates and layouts to a site view. Now, inside of the site view, we see that we are loading Preacher Panel and Preacher Small and Preacher Box. So let's go look at how to create those templates. We'll go to templates, and then here they are already created. You could click on new to start with a new template. You could also copy an old one by selecting the template you would like to copy. Click on batch, and then there's a copy feature here, and click process, and it will copy it for you. Okay, so here I have Preacher Panel open. In Preacher Panel, it's the same concept. It's an HTML area, so if I want to use PHP, I need to go into the PHP, and then I can go out again. And I can also add this text placeholders, which helps us to ensure that the text itself is translatable. You can just do your normal English text like that, sermon count and sermon total downloads. And Component Builder will add these strings to the language file for you, and you don't need to be concerned, though at this stage it only does your British English language file. And if you need to add more languages, you'll need to look up the documentation of adding languages to a third-party extension and do that same implementation. So here we see that you can add layouts to this template by using any of these snippets. To this template. And you can add other templates to it. So you can use templates inside of templates, and you could use layouts as well. So more or less the same behavior as in site view. You also have your snippet box here, which you can make use of adding script quickly to your page like that. Refresh. We see that that script that I've just looked at here in the Preacher Panel, if we go to the code, Preacher Panel, it's exactly the same script that you're seeing here. Okay, now there are a few exciting points here. Let me see. One of them, as a side note, is that in your details tab in the template area here at the bottom, you can add JavaScript with your normal script tags. And so you can just add your JavaScript in there, and it'll work and be loaded into the page through this little snippet. That's a nice thing to know. As well as you still have access, as I said before, to all the global this field values, like you can see there. You can access those quite easily. And that is basically how to set up a template. It's the same kind of conventions as setting up a site view, except that this is not the main view. It is a template used somewhere in a main view through adding this code snippet with the Joomla class get template method, and then basically this load template is the method that is being used with that name, and then it adds it to your component site view, as well as adds the code to it and everything else. So that is a template. Next up, let's look at a layout. It really gets excited there.